Welcome everyone to a narrative Kenshi series. This playthrough is going to follow Blacktooth, whose main goal is to become king in the world of Kenshi. Blacktooth lives in the town of Stack, a holy nation city that's pretty quiet for the most part, with holy nation patrols constantly fucking him around. Today started out like most days, where Blacktooth needed to go get some money. Heading out of the city, he would make his way to a mine, as he needed to get some type of resource to sell in exchange for food. Blacktooth had grown up in Stack and spent most of his life there, not adventuring very far out of the city. The world of Kenshi is a dangerous place, and with many different bandit groups, cannibals, slavers, Blacktooth knows that if he was to go out by himself, he'd just be dead. He would spend the next few hours, though, mining away at copper, looking over his shoulder, making sure nobody would ambush him. Luckily though, with Holy Nation patrols going by, he'd have little to no worries, and he usually wouldn't step more than 30 seconds away from the city, so if he did get attacked, he'd be fine. After about 5 hours though, he gathered 2 copper, and as pathetic as that was, he would have to run back and sell it, that way he could get some food. Walking through the city of Stack, Blacktooth would make his way to the bar, where a majority of the people in the bar would diminish him for being poor. Blacktooth, you here to fucking beg for food? We only take cats. Fuck off, I have copper to sell for ore. Oh wow, you actually went to fucking work? That's impressive, Blacktooth, okay. If Blacktooth was to fight anyone in the bar, not only would he get his ass kicked by the person in the bar, but guards would kill him. He's learned this a couple times before, so he just makes his way out peacefully. Now, tired of being so poor, he wants to get money, he wants to steal something. Going on top of stores though, there's not much around that's easy to steal. Most things have a low percentage chance. Even heading to a different store without anyone there, he was able to only find holy Bibles. And with guards coming up right after to call him trash, Blacktooth, you're fucking trash, get out of here. He would have to leave the top of the building before being attacked, and seeing as the guards would carry giant fucking maces, he knew that he stood little to no chance. There wasn't much to do to make money around Stack, there's no jobs, and most people don't have that much to steal, so Blacktooth would just increase his stealth skill and wait for a good opportunity to strike. Later on in the night, luckily, the guards had been attacked by a group of bone dogs. Now this meant that Blacktooth could run over to the bone dogs, try and fight them for some experience, but then also loot their corpses. Heading over, Blacktooth was able to get a pretty full inventory of random animal parts, leaving the last bone dog with some stuff. He'd pick it up, that way he could run around and get some strength XP. This would at least assure that if he got it to a decent level, he wouldn't be as easily knocked out or killed while in battle. And doing this for the next day and a half, he would get his skill up to about level 17. But by this time, the bone dog corpse was starting to rot. It had flies around it, so heading to sell all the goods that he had gotten from the vicious bone dog attack. Blacktooth had 1800 cats and a strength level of 18, so not too bad compared to 2 days ago. He'd also go set up a campfire outside of the city, cook up the raw meat that he had found. He went to talk to a local passerby, but when asked about work, they told him to head to the bar and stop being lazy. Heading to the bar though, there wasn't too much for work. There's a few traders nearby and a few other people that could possibly be recruited. One warrior named Grim sitting at the table claimed to have a pretty deep story. He tells us he made 60 cats a day, and then right after that says that he will only work for us for 35k cats. Blacktooth does not have that much. Along with other person in the bar who Blacktooth would go on to piss off and end up fighting. This would end up causing a huge bar fight in which the mercenary warrior we talked to before was now fighting people, and he ended up knocking out the belt trader. Now, this was actually great because this would give Blacktooth a perfect opportunity to loot some corpses, as he wasn't knocked out yet and he could make his escape pretty easily. Checking the belt trader's inventory, he had lots of different belts and different things, a few K-cats for sure, plus a backpack. Once stealing everything though, he did get caught, so he had to wait out. So Blacktooth waited out on top of a roof until the authorities weren't looking for him. And heading outside, Grim had taken the bar fight outside into the public, where at first he was stomping local civilians, but then the Holy Nation army came up on him and fucking smash-broed him into the wall. When trying to loot Grim, he was taken away way too fast for us to even go and try and grab him, so he's most likely going to be sold into slavery, never seen again. On the bright side though, he helped us out big time because we now had 9.5k cats from selling all the belts and such. This was a perfect opportunity for Blacktooth to buy his first home, as he had been homeless his entire life. Now being able to build this home and have a place in stack, he would be able to do things like research or store his goods there, not have to worry about carrying everything on him or only keeping a few close personal possessions. It was small, but it was a lot more than he had had. Now inside of there, he would first put down a research bench, as it was his main priority to start learning more about the world. To become king, Blacktooth would need to make great technology advances for the world, as at this point technology wasn't too advanced. After this, he would head to the bar to find somebody to hopefully work for him, and after looking around, there was a woman sitting at a table named Zula. When talking to her, she tells us about her little sister who was burned to death by the Holy Nation the month previous. The Holy Nation now goes on to harass her every day, and she's looking for an escape. For 3,000 cats, we end up recruiting her, and this is a pretty good addition to the team. Seeing as two is twice as many as one, Blacktooth now had his first vassal. Heading back to the home Blacktooth had built, they would go on to research some basic technologies for storage and other things, and then placing down some storage chests. That way, Blacktooth could begin production on mining. With Blacktooth researching, Zula would be able to go to the stores, buy the goods, and then construct the things, all while we're getting other things done in the process. After this, I selected an iron ore node and sent Zula to go over there and mine it. With her mining, we would be passively making income and being able to upkeep our expenses. And with the ore being not too far from the city, we'd probably be able to save her if things got too dangerous. And Blacktooth would be pretty safe for the time being inside researching. Blacktooth needed to find more servants though, because he couldn't just have one person working for him. And looking in the bar, there was only one person who looked like they were pretty poor and weak. This man was Bart, a drunk old man sitting in the bar. After rambling on to us, he told us that if we pay his bar tab, he'd gladly join our party. So for 3,000 cats like that, we had recruited Bard. Excited to get into the world and start helping Blacktooth and his cause, he would go immediately to go help Zula mine. This would also allow Zula to have a little bit of backup or support if she did get attacked by bandits. So things were looking pretty good at this point for Blacktooth and his group. Blacktooth was tired of staying inside of a city though. He wanted to travel on outskirts of Stack. With many different bandit groups walking by, he could easily lure one of them back to the city gates, he thought, in order to loot them for their stuff. First, he would attract a couple hungry bandits and bring them over near the ore node where Zula and Bard were working. This would then lead into Blacktooth's first real fight against anyone in the wild, and he would prove to do quite alright. Same with Zula, even though they had little to no combat experience, they'd be able to take out the duo of hungry bandits without getting too hurt. Blacktooth would also pick up a hungry bandit, that way he could get his strength training up hopefully, as it was at 20, but if he could get it a bit higher, he would just be a bit better off than not having the high strength stat. A problem had arose though. We were getting attacked this time. Zula and Bard were getting attacked by hungry bandits, and a whole group of them, like a big swarm. So bringing them back to the gate, they would have to initiate combat with them, and I thought the guards would have came out and helped like a little bit sooner, but it took them a little bit to come over. Either way though, we were still doing alright and pretty fair against the hungry bandits. Not too much to worry about when most of her hits aren't that deadly and they don't really have a chance to disarm us or anything. But they would knock out the entire party, and even Blacktooth wouldn't be able to get up without being shot down by one of the people arming a crossbow. After we fight though, the Holy Nation had cleaned up pretty well, and Zula was the first to awaken, so she patched everyone up. It would then be her job to pick up everyone and first bring one to the near the gate, and then the other to the bar. Even though Blacktooth was at the gate, there wasn't too much to worry about with groups of ninjas walking by and traders, as well as the protection of the guards that were a few feet away. There would be a very low chance of him being in any danger. The party would sleep for the next half a day in order to heal their wounds that they had sustained. Once waking up, going back to mining to get that money. Now Blacktooth had not learned from his mistake though, and he wanted to go out again and try and get bandits to the city gates. Now, even though it was the middle of the night, he'd go looking until the morning, where a group of triage bandits would run after him. Now, problem was, though, he was way too slow with his backpack weighing 50 kilograms, so he ended up getting knocked out, and when waking up, he would run back to the city to go inside and figure out something safer to do. Back to research it was, and with that, Blacktooth also decided he was going to put in a general storage chest, that way he could unequip that fucking 120-pound backpack of his. With a weight off his shoulders, he could now train his stealth level a little bit more and try to sneak into some places. Breaking into the hardware store at night, he would successfully enter in, but immediately be stopped by the shopkeeper, who would wake up being chased to the back of the store. The shopkeeper would not let Blacktooth escape without a beating, and beat him down, with Blacktooth landing a hit, which was nice, but it was nothing compared to the 4 hits to the chest that the shopkeeper had dealt Blacktooth. Once he woke up, though, he would just decide that it wasn't a big place that he should break into. This time, he would try breaking into a smaller place, like a house. This house didn't have too much in it, and he didn't want to wake up the people and then have to fight more people, so he just stole a few pieces of food that were on the tables and got out quickly. It wasn't much, but it was a day of free food and a successful heist. Once Blacktooth had set up a training dummy, he would be able to train up his melee attack up to level 5, so he wouldn't be as bad as the level 2 and 1s that he would be going against in the wild. Going from one side of the town to the other, Blacktooth would train his strength for the next couple days in order to get it to a higher level. Now, during this, the idiot controlling Blacktooth decided to smoke some weed, and this led to Bard being knocked out. Now, 3 in-game hours went by, and Bard was almost dead by the time I saw him, and the moment I unpaused, he died. Zula, heading back, was very unimpressed with Blacktooth, as she was screaming for his assistance the entire time, and where was he? Smoking fucking weed. She wasn't gonna go back mining anytime soon, at least not right now, as that was bullshit. Pissed off, Zula would convince Blacktooth that they needed to go retrieve Bard's corpse, and sneaking over to the corpse, the bone dogs were still there, chewing on his limbs. Quickly running in and grabbing Bard, they would make their escape and head back to near the city. Now, beside the city, there's a little hilly area, so they put him in there, as they didn't really have a place to bury him. Blacktooth, looking at the person he had just became friends with a couple days ago, with no arms or legs, kinda shocked him. With this, it taught him that him and Zula would definitely need to get their stats up, as if they didn't have a good strength level, they wouldn't stand a chance in this wasteland hellhole that is Kenshi. Throughout one of the nights, though, a guard would get attacked by a bone dog and actually backed up into a wall. Now, this was great, as it would not only mean we could loot the bone dog after it got killed, but we could loot the Holy Nation guard. Going ham on his inventory, we were able to get quite a few things, some armor, some weapons, some cats, a few med kits, as well as being able to sneak away without being caught. It was a great opportunity that was jumped on. Now, at this point, Zula didn't really know what she was working for. She just knew she was helping Blacktooth become some type of king. When asked about if he was looking to be the type of king that Lord Phoenix was, Blacktooth really resents Lord Phoenix for the fact that he blames him for how shit the economy is and how there aren't any jobs or places to really live. Blacktooth wanted to take over the land and make it a better place, somewhere where you could go outside and not get smacked in the face with a wooden stick from a bandit. After a few days of strength training, though, they head back to the house and drop the bodies that they've been carrying for the past few days, as they needed to get on some kind of cash flow again. This time, though, they would be going to mine iron, both Blacktooth and Zula. Blacktooth knew now that he couldn't just be smoking weed while his workers were out working away, so he would help Zula collect copper, along with staying away from the iron ore node, as the bone dogs were still there and unpredictable as can be. We wouldn't know if they would strike again. Blacktooth would go and sell all the iron that they had collected from the past few days.
Here to beg for some fucking cats.
Actually, no, you fucking dwarf idiot. I got plenty of iron for sale. Making a few thousand cats off iron, we were just short of enough money for a new recruit.
The next few days would be spent mining copper, though, as it was a very profitable resource, almost twice as much as iron, and this ore node was closer to the city. After a couple days, they'd gathered 75 copper, and bringing that to the barkeep, he wouldn't even have enough money to buy it all. How does it feel, you fucking gremlin-looking idiot? Now you're the one who has no money and only ore in your pockets. Selling the rest of the copper, though, we were able to make a lot of money, over 10k cats, and that would be more than enough to get a new recruit. In the bar, sitting down, wearing some bandit-looking-like gear, there was one person there that we could possibly recruit. His name was Glass. When asked if he was a bandit, he goes and tells us straight up that he was, and he decided to pay off his bounty and do his time, and that now he was just looking for work. He says 5,500 cats, and with him having about level 10 in most of his skills, it wouldn't be too bad of an investment, and with that, Glass would join the team. Now, Blacktooth would decide to put Glass onto researching, as him and Zula had been getting their laboring skill up quite a bit, and it would be safer for him to be inside and have Blacktooth outside. With Glass researching new technologies and Blacktooth getting more experience in the outside world, things were looking up. Bard's death could at least be looked at as a learning example. And after selling a bunch of copper that they had collected over another few days, they had enough money to go and recruit a new servant for Blacktooth. Zula found a man named Okuro at the bar who, when offered 6,500 cats to join our squad, he immediately joins us. Things were pretty good. Even though Blacktooth and Zula would be getting attacked occasionally, it would only be in small groups, like one or two triage bandits, so they were getting quite a bit of nice combat experience while mining. Now, Okuro had pretty nice stats, and we decided to put him on strength training as it was his only stat that wasn't leveled up a bit. On day 14, though, a huge group of hungry bandits had attacked Blacktooth and Zula while mining, gathering all of his party to go to the gates of Stack. Zula would be knocked out before she could make her escape. This would leave Blacktooth, Glass, and Okuro left to fight the rest of the hungry bandits while waiting for Holy Nation backup to arrive. Even though a patrol was passing, they wouldn't help Blacktooth or his friends. Even though he put up a good fight and took out a few of them, Blacktooth would go down, eventually leaving Okuro to stumble out and fight the rest of them with a Holy Nation guard. After the battle though, Okuro was able to heal up everyone and get them patched up and brought to the bar. Everyone would spend the next few hours at the bar healing up as they need to prepare to leave Stack. Blacktooth had heard of a place called The Hub from when he was a kid, a place full of economic trade, diversity, and work. And as mining had been getting them a little bit somewhere in Stack, it wasn't getting them far enough. So selling the copper that they had mined, having over 10k cats again, now would be invested into some building materials, and they would go on their way out of Stack to the hub, not knowing what led to the hub, what would meet them on the way there, or once they got there. They would travel into the desert unknowingly, hoping for the best. This would be the end of the second week of Blacktooth's tale, where he strives to become king.